Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Just Ash here. First off, I want to say a big thank you to all my new subscribers, and hey to my day ones for coming back and checking up on your girl. As always, I do appreciate all the love and support, and continue to like, comment, and share these videos where you share videos. And in today's video, I'll be talking about a few tips that has helped me on downsizing my hair product stash. I mentioned several times here on my channel of how I'm working towards using up the products that I have in my product stash. And now that spring is approaching, I definitely have that spring cleaning bug, and I have gotten rid of so many products and used up so many products that I thought these tips would be helpful for anyone that is looking to do the same. And this is not only for people that are hair product junkies like I am. This will definitely help makeup and skincare junkies. So please stay tuned for the tips. I know you guys may be wondering, girl, did you get a relaxer? And the answer is no. I just flat ironed my hair. And if you guys are curious to know how I flat iron my hair, I definitely have a video on that, and I'll link it down below. But I am coming up on my second relaxer for the year, so definitely look out for that video to come. But no, I just flat ironed my hair because this was my mom's birthday this past week, so happy birthday, Mom. Moving right along to the tips. Tip number one would be to declutter. How I decluttered was to create three piles, one being a toss pile, two being a giveaway pile, and the third pile was a keep pile. And these piles definitely cut down on a lot of products. The toss pile, of course, is products that you wouldn't give away or keep. One way you know that a product is ready to be tossed, if it has collected dust. That product, you haven't used it in a while, and the formulation may have separated as well. So that's a definite reason to get rid of that product. And as well as products you don't like. That could go for either toss or giveaway. I gave away a lot of products that I didn't even know why I purchased. I definitely think it was because of the hype. I gave away products that I did not like the ingredient list. So definitely was giving that away. And now I was left with fewer products with that process alone. So first step definitely is to declutter. Tip number two is to organize. The way I organize my products now is into four categories. Category one being shampoos and conditioners. I just lumped them into one. Second category is my deep conditioner. Third category is my leave-in and stylers, which to be honest is just all leave-ins. And fourth would be my oils. So I kept it quite simple, and it just have made wash day that much easier. I can go into each category and just pick out what I need without rummaging through a whole bunch of products, products that are old and products that I don't like. So now that we have decluttered and organized, we're moving on to tip number three, which is to only buy essentials. The way you can determine when a product is an essential, if you have organized your products. So when I have organized my products, I determined I really didn't have any more oils, and I definitely needed to purchase that because I am a big fan of using oils in my hair during wash day and just oils in general. So that gave me the opportunity to go out and purchase just that product. So I wasn't in the store looking at shampoos, looking at deep conditioners. I went with a more focused mindset, and that definitely helped. Tip number four is to reward yourself. If I didn't mention, this is a kind of a journey. It's not one day you wake up and you're like, poof, I used up all my products, or let me toss all my products away. This is definitely a work in progress. So you want to reward yourself. The way I reward myself is every 5 to 7 products that I use, I like to purchase something nice for myself. It could be another hair product or it's not another hair product, but I definitely like to reward myself so that I can continue on using up the product and just getting down to a more manageable amount. So these are my tips. Hopefully you have found them helpful. And as always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.